Hello all, welcome back to my channel. This is Dr. Sonia Musakuti and today in my video I will be dealing with the fractures of middle third of facial skeleton. So when compared to the fractures of mandible, the frequency of fractures of middle third of face is less. So before going into the topic, if you are new here, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and if you like this video, click the like button. So coming into the topic, so what is actually this middle third of the face? The middle third of the facial skeleton is defined as an area which is bounded superiorly by a line drawn across the skull from the zygomaticofrontal suture of one side across the frontonasal and frontomaxillary sutures to the zygomaticofrontal suture on the opposite side, and bounded inferiorly by the occlusal plane of the upper teeth, or if the patient is edentulous, by the upper alveolar ridge. Now we can discuss about the nerve supply of the middle third of the face. Normally, the middle third of the face receives the nerve supply from the second division of trigeminal nerve. Other nerves like infraorbital nerve, the palatine branches and the nasopalatine nerve also innervate the middle third of the face. The infraorbital nerve innervates the soft tissues of the lower eyelid, the cheek, the lateral aspect of the nose and the upper lip. The palatine branches innervate the mucosa of the palate. The nasopalatine nerve innervates the mucosa of the anterior palatine area. The blood vessels supplying the middle third of the face is the third part of the maxillary artery and its terminal branches. Now we can go into the details of classification of the middle third fractures. A French surgeon named René Lefort in 1901 discovered that the complex fracture patterns can be subdivided into three groups: Lefort 1, Lefort 2 and Lefort 3. Other surgeons like Eric also classified these fractures as per the direction of the fracture line. These include the horizontal fracture, the pyramidal fracture and the transverse fracture. The most universally used classification is the Lefort classification. So first we can discuss the Lefort 1 fracture. This Lefort 1 fracture is also called as the low level fracture or the subzygomatic fracture. It can be also called as the horizontal fracture of maxilla, the Guerin's fracture or the floating fracture. A violent force which is made above the level of the teeth result in this Lefort 1 fracture. This Lefort 1 fracture is also called as floating fracture because there is a separation of the complete dendoalveolar part of the maxilla and the fractured fragment is held only by the means of soft tissues. So, coming into the course of fracture line in case of Lefort 1 fracture. The fracture line of the Lefort 1 fracture commences at the point on the lateral margin of the anterior nasal aperture, which passes above the nasal floor and passes laterally above the canine fossa and transverses the lateral antral wall, which then dips down below the zygomatic buttress and then inclines upward and posteriorly across the pterygomaxillary fissure to fracture the pterygoid laminae at the junction of the lower third and upper two third. Next, we can go through the clinical signs and symptoms of Lefort 1 fracture. Studying and memorizing all the clinical signs and symptoms of the Lefort fracture will find it difficult. So I have made up a simple mnemonic for the Lefort 1 fracture. So the mnemonic is SEBUM PPTU. Here, the S stands for slight swelling and edema of the lower part of the face. The E stands for the ecchymosis of the labial and buccal vestibule. The B stands for the bilateral epistasis or the nasal bleeding. The O stands for the occlusion is disturbed, so the patient finds it difficult to masticate the food. The M stands for the mobility of the upper dendoalveolar portion. The P stands for pain while speaking and moving the jaw. The other P stands for the percussion of the maxillary teeth produces a dull cracked up sound. The T stands for the telescopic fracture or the impacted fracture. That means the upward displacement of the entire fragment, locking it against the superior intact structures, and this type of fracture is called as the impacted or the telescopic fracture. The U stands for the upper lip features, that is, there is swelling of the upper lip, conduction of the skin of the upper lip and laceration of the upper lip along with the intraoral mucosa. So the next fracture is the Lefort 2 fracture. It is also called as the pyramidal fracture or the subzygomatic fracture. As I told earlier about the leaf out one fracture, the violent force is applied above the level of the teeth. In case of leaf out two fracture, the violent force is delivered at the level of the nasal bones. Next, we can discuss about the clinical signs and symptoms of leaf out two fracture. The mnemonic here is B5 SCODA. The 5 B's stands for ballooning or moon face, which means there is a gross edema of the middle third of the face, bilateral circumorbital edema and ecchymosis, bilateral subconjunctival hemorrhage, the bridge of the nose is depressed, which is flat face, bilateral epistasis. The 2 S stands for surgical emphysema, that is a crackling sensation which is transmitted to the fingers due to the escape of air from the paranasal sinus, and step deformity at the infraorbital margins. The C represents the CSF leak. The 2 O is the occlusion is disturbed and there is obstruction of the airway. The 2 D stands for the dish-shaped face and difficulty in mastication and speech. And the A stands for anesthesia or paresthesia of the cheek. So that comes to an end of the leaf out fracture 2. So now we can go into the leaf out 3 fracture. This leaf out 3 fracture is also called as the transverse fracture or the suprazygomatic fracture. It is also called as the high level fracture. Here, the fracture is due to the trauma which is inflicted over a wider area at the orbital level. The clinical signs and symptoms of the leaf out 3 fracture include panda faces, raccoon eyes, bilateral subconjunctival hemorrhage, unilateral or bilateral hooding of the eyes, dish face deformity, enophthalmos, diplopia or impairment of the vision, temporary blindness, flattening and widening, deviation of the nasal bridge, epistasis, CSF rhinorrhea and so on. The maxillary teeth in most instances being tilted downward and backward, so there is gagging of teeth with anterior open bite. So as this video is huge, I will be dividing this topic into two. So in the next video, I will be mainly dealing with the fractures of zygomatic complex and the treatment of the middle third fractures. So till then, it's Dr. Sonia signing off. Thank you.